So good morning children. So let us continue today with our previous topic. So we were discussing about what children? The Mendeley's periodic table. And we also came to know that what were the merits and the demerits of Mendeley. So merits were of course many we can say, because he systematically arranged them in a proper in the increasing order of their atomic masses, and he also correlated them to their chemical and physical properties. Then he also discovered, he also predicted what that new elements will be discovered, and he also predicted the properties of some unknown elements. But now let us focus on the demerits of the Mendeley's periodic table. So if you can recall, there were four major drawbacks of the Mendeley's periodic table, which we can call it as anomaly or the limitation or the demerit or the drawback. So the first one was hydrogen was not assigned a proper position, because as per the increasing order, Mendeley was right, positioning it in the first period, first group. Okay, but then when coming to the properties, the chemical and the physical properties of the hydrogen are similar to whom? Similar to halogens. Now, what are halogens? Halogens are your chlorine, fluorine, which exist in molecular state. So, same like how chlorine will be existing as Cl2, okay, and then bromine will be existing as Br2, same even hydrogen exists in molecular state. And it is also gaseous like these compounds, fine, and also non-metallic by nature. But then it was similar to alkali metals with whom it was placed, that is sodium and potassium, in terms of its reaction, because it can also combine with chlorine or bromine, like how sodium and potassium combine with chlorine and bromine. So we could not just he also could not give a proper reason, but nevertheless it was placed as per its atomic mass in the period 1, group 1. And the second drawback was isotope position was not justified, because as per his statement, elements were arranged in the increasing order of atomic masses. So as per that, if I take up an example of chlorine, chlorine will have two isotopes. One is Cl35 and the other is Cl37. So both were kept in the same box. Okay, so that was also one of the drawback. Then coming to another drawback, the increasing order of atomic mass was not maintained. Wherein, that means atomic atom with more element with more atomic mass was placed before the element with lesser atomic mass. Okay, for example, the placement of cobalt and nickel. Cobalt had more atomic mass when compared to nickel, but still it was placed prior before the nickel. This was another drawback. Coming to the last and the most important drawback was, he could not predict that how many elements would be discovered between two elements. Why? Because the atomic mass was not increasing in a definite amount. Okay, so there were lot of variations between mass of one element to the other element. So the prediction was not possible. So these were the major drawbacks. Then, what was the conclusion drawn from these demerits of the Mendeley's classification? That atomic mass cannot be the criteria for classification or arrangement of elements. Why? The reason is atomic mass does not increase in a set pattern or set amount. So when scientists started doing a research, then they came to a conclusion that instead of, if this atomic mass is replaced by atomic number, if atomic mass is replaced by atomic number, all these anomalies, most of the anomalies of Mendeley's could be solved. Okay, so then what happened? A new law was proposed wherein the properties of the elements were the periodic function of atomic mass but not atomic number. So this was only the modern periodic law. Now the question comes, who proposed this? The first attempt was made by a scientist named Henry Moseley, who came to a conclusion that atomic number could be the most justifiable and satisfactory criteria for arrangement of elements in a periodic table. So without bringing much change in the periodic table of Mendeley, the elements were arranged as per the atomic number. Thereby
giving a very systematic arrangement to the elements in the periodic table. Now the question comes, why atomic number was taken as a criteria? As you all know, in your previous standard, you all have learned what is atomic number. Atomic number is nothing but number of protons, okay, number of protons in an element or in an atom. So number of protons in an atom, which are always fixed, okay, or this is also equal to nothing but number of electrons. But since electrons participate in the chemical reactions, so we will be taking number of protons only as the standard atomic number. So now, how does this atomic number differ from one element to another? Let us take an example. Let us take the first element, hydrogen, whose atomic number is how much? 1. Similarly, helium, whose atomic number is 2. Then comes lithium, atomic number 3. Then comes beryllium, atomic number 4. Now observe, between hydrogen to helium, how much is the difference of value? It is 1. Similarly, from helium to lithium, it is 1. From lithium to beryllium, it is 1. So you see now, as the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number, the arrangement is very systematic. The reason is the difference in the atomic number is how much? 1. So it is fixed, whether it is from hydrogen to helium, helium to lithium, lithium to beryllium, or beryllium to boron. So since the difference of value is 1, which is fixed, so we can predict that how many elements would be discovered between the two elements. So the first anomaly was clarified. Then coming to the second point, second drawback, the increasing order of the atomic mass was not maintained. So if we take up the atomic number as the criteria, we all know that the atomic number of cobalt is 28, where nickel is how much? 29. So this their position also was justified. Then another drawback, what was it? Isotope position was not justified, because as we told, isotopes are same atomic number, different atomic mass. So now even that problem was solved. So when Cl35 and Cl37 were placed in the same box, it was justified, because the chlorine atomic number is how much? 17, which is same for equal both same for both chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. Clear? So what happened? Now the atomic number led to the clarification of the demerits of Mendeleev. Then comes the question. When we are talking about atomic number, when we are talking about the atomic number, we are talking about the arrangement of the electrons. So that led to what? Electronic configuration. You all have even learned about this in your standard 9. So we have designed the electronic configuration of each and every element. So based on their electronic configurations, the elements were arranged in the periodic table. Okay, so thereby maximum, we cannot say that the modern periodic table is a foolproof periodic table. It has its own limitations that we will be discussing later. But most of the demerits or the limitations of the Mendeleev's tables were clarified once the atomic mass was shifted to atomic number. Clear, children? So today we discussed how Mendeleev's demerits have been justified or clarified by the modern periodic table. So we'll continue about the long form of periodic table in our next session. Kindly go through the textbook. Thank you.